I'm Ron Brown. Join me as I travel across the world to peek over the shoulders of the most talented, most dedicated, and most respected chefs on the planet as we meet the chefs of the great hotels of the world.
I'm going inside the Peace Hotel to meet Executive Chef Gu, who's going to introduce us to some of the traditional flavours of Shanghai.
The Peace Hotel has been a landmark in Shanghai for over a century and is the most famous hotel in China. The first of its two buildings, the South Building, was originally known as the Palace Hotel and was constructed in 1906. The second, now the North Building, was originally known as the Cafe Hotel and was opened in 1929. It's an Art Deco masterpiece. The hotel buildings were seized by the People's Government in 1949. The buildings were later renovated after extensive damage by the Japanese military in the war and reopened in 1956 as the Peace Hotel. After a look around, I met up with Chef Gu in the main dining room.
My name is Gu. 我进和平饭店已经有30多年了，从71年进和平饭店的。Given
this hotel has been here 100 years, and given the history of China with its revolutions and economic challenges, it's not surprising the Peace Hotel kitchens still have that patina so reminiscent of well-used food preparation surfaces. The chipped and cracked tiles, the age-worn benches, and the communal work areas. It's a beehive of activity everywhere I look. This hotel has been hard at work for many years, feeding many guests. Chinese kitchens are organised quite differently to Western kitchens. Not only is the emphasis on wok cooking rather than pots and pans, but the personnel are allocated into two streams. The chopper chefs who cut the ingredients for each dish, and the wok chefs who actually combine the ingredients during cooking. And unlike the Western kitchen, where a young chef aspires to move through the ranks to head chef status, designing menus and supervising others, the Chinese kitchen has the two streams, each with its own senior practitioner. As a result, the Chinese have developed some pretty fancy chopper work over the centuries, and fruit and vegetable carving is a highly regarded skill. Cold dishes based around intricate carving of vegetables, such as this signature rooster dish celebrating the year of the rooster, are one result.
It's a design that is very beautiful.
Around about now, if you think like me, you're starting to really respect this chef for his application to detail and his fine chopping skills. Plus, he has the whole picture of how this rooster is going to look mapped out in his head. I'm not sure how many times he's done this before, but it's pretty impressive anyway. This kind of slow, methodical manual work by a top chef is probably not economically justified in places where either salaries are higher or the price of the dish is lower, or both. This is probably a dying trade, as we like to say in the West, and may not be seen for much longer even in China, where the headlong rush to get ahead in the 21st century is sweeping this kind of time-intensive approach to presentation aside.
第二个热菜呢，就是松子东星斑的，它这个原料呢，因为我们 所以我们把这个菜呢去刮，最后呢放在油里面三分以后炸。
炸得里面嫩，外面串，是吧？回去呢，炖上糖醋的沙司，是吧？这样的，许多外国人呢相当欢迎。 这个菜呢，也是我们那个龙凤天的，特色的菜肴。
OK。